Good morning, students. So today we are in the previous topic we discussed about the cloud computing architecture, and also in the previous more topics we discussed about the infrastructures as implementation and also in a platform as an implementation. Along with an infrastructure implementation and a platform as an implementation, we also studied about the characteristics of the implementations. So as I told you, the physical hardware resources available in a different location, and we can convert them into a virtually, and I can also access and I can share the physical resources. So during that time also I discussed about what are the different types of clouds are going to come into a picture. So when I say about the different clouds, there was in the previous modules we discussed about a public cloud, we discussed about a private cloud, we discussed about a community cloud, we discussed about an economic cloud. So we discussed about the different categories of the clouds which are going to incorporate in the architecture diagram, such that we can access the resources through an internet centric information or through an interface between an internet and the storage devices. So same way here in the previous topic, we started in a session called as an hybrid computer. Always remember, hybrid cloud computing is in a combination or in a mixture of in a public public clouds and also in a private clouds. So with this discussion, as I told you, there you can see that whenever I say it is in a private cloud in turn will process the how I can access the IaaS and how I can access the PaaS, and then how I can execute it dynamically, how I can provision the data dynamically, how fast I can fetch the data, and I can give it an end user for the need. Understand? So these are all the discussions come into picture. When you see this diagram, you can also observe that there is a public cloud which is also interfacing with then another public cloud. So what I want to say, there are two different domains of public cloud which we are interfacing to each other through an internet. I am accessing some data from one cloud, I am accessing some data from another cloud. Now I am going to process with the some specific domain. If I say private, it is talks about only some organization, some enterprise, or some a specific work or a specific job I want to do. So during that time also, you can see I am going to access some data centers, I am going to use the clusters, I am going to use the desktop grids, and I can process it dynamically. So that is nothing but a combination of a private and a public cloud for processing the job or completing the task, and we are going to take an up. Clear? So this is called as a hybrid cloud computing. So this, I think we have discussed in the realistic classes, called as a community cloud. Community cloud is one of the cloud which always talks about a specific job, a specific domain. That is called as a community. So you can see here, there is one globe image. That is, you can imagine like an internet. Internet contains different types of clouds. You can see there is one cloud called as a federal and a government bodies cloud, which talks only about the government bodies and the federal information related in things. So that itself is independent private cloud. Suppose if I want to talk about in a public services, like it may be a doctor, it may be a military, those are all comes under one of the cloud called as a public cloud. There are some of the clouds called as a private users. I'm going to use it only for my particular job. I'm going to depend on that. I can process, I can share the information, all those things. That is private user. Similarly, you can see the industries, enterprises. So they are all comes under the one category called as a private cloud. So what we learned here, a community is a one cloud which talks about the task or the job or the functionality pertaining to one domain, one cadre or one parameter or one task, one set of jobs, one similarity of the jobs we can do. Some set of same set of jobs, a similarity of the jobs can be taken under the word called as a community cloud. Yes, now we will move on to the topic called as an Aneka framework with a diagram. So before going to the Aneka, so what we want to convey here, I want to just say you have studied the cloud computing architecture, you have studied about the infrastructure implementation, platform implementation, different types of clouds. You also know what is the pros and cons of a cloud computing, which I am not going to take up in this class. It is a self-explanatory, you should learn. I think we had a healthy discussion in the online classes also. So you must know what is the advantages of a cloud and what is a cloud computing and what is a disadvantages of a cloud computing. So in terms, they are also called as what is the pros and cons. What in many of the VTU question paper also we have seen, what is the pros and cons of a cloud computing. what is the pros and cons of a cloud computing. So please have a knowledge of that before coming. Say here, Aneka. Aneka is in a one of the cloud developed by the Rajkumar Bhuvia and the team. You just Google it, you'll come to know about the author. So you'll come to know how he has developed, what is the vision of that cloud, and how it has been processed. Now here we are going to develop the, we are going to learn the complete, in this curriculum, we are going to learn about the complete overview of one cloud called as Aneka cloud. Now before going to the Aneka cloud, you just have the infrastructure, or you can just see how actually the cloud looks. I am talking with respect to the engineering, or talking with respect to the technology, what the technology they have used. So you can also see now the cloud remains the same, whether it is in a Microsoft Aneka or it may be in a Microsoft Azure. These are the same standard parameters we are going to study here. So the innermost layer you can see in the diagram, it is an infrastructure. That is about your IaaS. Middle layer talks about your PaaS. Majorly we are talking about PaaS based on the application services, based on the foundation services, and based on the fabric services. So this is also called as a pre-essentials or a persistence and security. So this is called as a container. So we will going to study about this called as a platform abstraction layer. Okay, platform abstraction layer, which is a major concept of what we are going. Similarly, the outermost layer is an application development or application layer, which is an interface layer with respect to the web 2.0 or with respect to the interface through the internet. So this is about the things. Now my dear students, we are going to learn deeply about the application services, foundation services, and then a fabric services. What is mean by a fabric, what is mean by foundation level, and what is mean by a application level. So now, as of now, knowledge, keep in your mind, there is a one layer called as a container. Now container, what it is going to do, container is going to persistence and given a security to the data or to the processing, or for a while processing the data through in a cloud. So what type of services you can provide, what type of securities I can give. I can get an encryption data, I can provide the, I can restrict the application services like map reducing technology or a bag of tasks or about the distributed threads. That is one type of security. Similarly, what is a foundation services it is providing? It is talks about the storage limitations, it talks about the resources reservations, it talks about the billing and reporting, and it also talks about some of the licensing and the accounting details about the foundation level. Fabric level is means like a memberships. It talks about the hardware profiling. It talks about the resources available and how I can use as the provisioning dynamically, how I can use as hardware. Similarly, the high availability. So these are the some of the persistence and the security which we are going to learn in the next coming sessions about the platform abstraction layer. Or it is also called as a middleware container. Clear? Fine. This is talks about the Aneka cloud infrastructure overview. Now if I see from the top view how actually the Aneka looks, so you must have any knowledge what is mean by a platform. I think a PaaS, I'll just recall PaaS, platform abstraction layer, and you must know what is your upper layer called as an interface, that is a software as a service, or a web 2.0 or APIs, application program interface. You must always know your lower level, that is talks about the IaaS. Now with this knowledge, now we are going to study the Aneka cloud infrastructure. Aneka cloud infrastructure, if I see here, there is an internet. Through the internet, different peoples are going to process and access the data in different mode. So whenever I say Aneka, it is like, looks like in a cloud, it looks like in a community cloud. There is a one information called as a node manager and Aneka container. So the if you see that, this is about the some data. Similarly, node manager and Aneka container. Similarly, there is an Aneka repository, there is an Aneka container, so there is Aneka repositories, and there is altogether there is one management console. I can consolidate all the management. So what we see, Aneka is a one of the cloud which also always bounded with a node manager. You see every diagram, you can see there is node icon called as a node manager. So node manager, you can see like a container. Container contains three services: application services, foundation services, and fabric.